on, so let's see here. All right, just as far as the injuries go, Andrew Wiley was scratched right at the last minute there with a stomach illness, and they took him, they hurried him to the hospital and did some tests on him, and things worked out okay, but not feeling very well. Sneed hurt his right shoulder. I'll have some more things done on that tomorrow just to see what the see exactly what needs to happen there. Chris Jones tweaked his groin right at the end there. We'll just see how it works out for him. I thought a lot of people did a nice job. I'd start with the coordinators and the job that they did putting those game plans together, all three phases. And then I thought the players were tremendous in the job that the way they executed the game. I mean, it was so many people did so many good things. Our defense just was bearing down against what I consider one of the best offenses in this league. And, you know, for them to, for our defense to do that, that's something special. So take a lot of pride in that. And then offensively, I thought, the guys were able to score some points, which were important. We had the turnover that we wish we had back. We had a nice drive going there, but that's how it goes. But I just thought overall, against a team that I think is as well coached as any team in the league with John Harbaugh and his crew, I just thought it was a well executed game from the Chiefs' standpoint.
Let's go first to Adam Teicher. Go ahead, Adam.
Hey, Andy. You guys showed, even for you, some unusual offensive creativity tonight. The underhanded shovel pass, the pass to Eric Fisher, that wildcat reverse. How long, where'd you come up with all those things, and how long you've been working on them, and why was tonight the time to use those?
Well, we were hoping they would work, you know, so and start with, but there's nothing like Monday Night Football, right? So, but that doesn't mean, you know, that you stop there. I'm not saying that, but it's just a good time to use it.
Let's go next to Sam Mellinger. Go ahead, Sam.
Hey, Andy, you guys hadn't played your best, I think it's fair to say, against the Chargers. I know there's things that you'll pick out from this game, but I'm just curious, did you feel after the Chargers game that there was a special performance in this group tonight, that they were up for this in a different way?
I know we're capable of, and we were just okay against the Chargers. Listen, we won the game, which is hard to do in the National Football League, but we could have done a better job. And it starts with me. So, I mean, I look right in the mirror on that first. And, I didn't do a great job of setting the guys up. And listen, we got another big one this next week, right? So every week in this league, you got another one rolling in. So we hear the New England's coming in, and they're playing good football. So we've got to get ourselves back and healed up a little bit on the soreness, and we're playing tonight, physical game, get ourselves right for this next week.
Let's go next to Pete Sweeney. Go ahead, Pete.
Coach, congratulations on the win game plan. Curious about the Eric Fisher play with the Ravens kind of swinging the momentum a little bit. Why that play call at that time? Why do you think it worked with Fisher catching the touchdown?
Well, we put it in a training camp. We worked on it there a little bit when you guys weren't looking. So we were able to pull it out and use it here. So Fish is always, he's always bragging about how good his hands are, but he did a pretty good job with it. I got to give him credit on that one. I was a little nervous when he had to jump, but he did a nice job.
Let's go next to Aaron Ladd. Go ahead, Aaron.
Coach, I felt like the first two quarters, you guys looked like a version of the team that we're used to seeing. Did you feel like that was the best half you all had played so far?
Yeah, that was it was a good half. Could have been better, but it was a good half. And we still have a ton of things we can work on here and clean up, and we'll do that, when we get back and get ourselves settled here.
Let's go next to Nate Taylor. Go ahead, Nate.
Hey, Andy, I'm wondering what you have found to be the true success when a team that you know is blitzing is going to blitz you throughout the game? And just what did you see from your offensive line and Patrick when recognized that the blitz was coming?
Yeah, well, they do a bunch of different things. So that's the tricky part about this. And, but I'm proud of our offensive line because really none of that happens without without them. So I thought they did a nice job picking things up. Our running backs, when asked, did a nice job. And we even include the tight ends on some of the stuff. So all in all, I just thought it was, you know, the guys executed. And, that's a tough – it's tough. Well, I'll tell you, you don't know – it's hard to get a read on them, and Wink does a nice job with that defense. And so you got to give credit to Pat and for leading the charge there. I mean, he stepped up big and wanted the responsibility of leading the charge and did a great job with it.
Let's go next to Sam McDowell. Go ahead, Sam.
Hey, Andy. Kind of to build off what Nate just asked, Patrick mentioned last year that he saw one look that he hadn't seen before from this team. So you guys were still able to beat it. I'm wondering if just quickly – based on what you saw without seeing the film, how much of what you saw tonight was stuff that maybe you hadn't seen previously on film that you were still able to have some success against?
Sam, they do about everything and anything that you can possibly see, and they just do it naturally. I don't know how they learn all of it, but they do, and they do it so well and accurate. And so there are a couple – they always have a little wrinkle for you every time you play them. So there was a new in there, but you know, you can't possibly cover all the different things that they do. I mean, you just have to stay disciplined in your rules and go with it from there.
Let's go next to Todd Lebo. Go ahead, Todd.
Hey, Coach, speaking of discipline, it looked like your front four was really disciplined with Lamar Jackson. He had the early run, but he wasn't really able to beat you guys with the scramble. How difficult was that to kind of prepare for, and how proud are you of the guys for the job they did tonight in that facet?
Yeah, well, it all starts there up front. And those guys, I think you're right on that. I just thought that when they got into position, you want naturally to charge the quarterback. If you do that with him, it's over. So to keep contained ends up being a huge thing. And he's faster than most of your guys on the field, right? So you see him run away from people, whether it's a cornerback or not. I mean, he can go. He's as fast as anybody out there. So, you know, for you to stay disciplined, that means a lot. It takes a lot to do that. And I was proud of our guys for that, staying disciplined.
We've got time for a couple more. We'll go Robert and then Herbie. Go ahead, Robert.
Hey, Coach. So, rightfully so, you get a lot of the credit for a lot of the more exotic play calls, especially the ones that were called today. And I know you've said it on many occasions, but can you just kind of reiterate how important Eric Bieniemy is to the play calling, and especially those more exotic plays like the TD to Fisher?
Yeah, no, he's my right-hand man there. Yeah, he's fully in charge and has a great feel for everything we do. I mean, listen, he was one of my players, so I'm proud as can be of him. And now I have a chance to coach with him. And, you know, I was dreading having possibly to lose him last year, but I'm glad he's back from my standpoint, kind of selfishly. But I know he's not going to be here very long. But I'm going to enjoy every minute I have a chance to spend with him.
Go last to Herbie. Go ahead, Herbie.
Hey, Coach, good evening. You guys limited the Ravens 166 total yards below what they were averaging coming in. And just to piggyback off of what Todd was asking there, how amped up was your defensive group coming into this game, especially knowing they were going against Lamar Jackson?
Well, yeah, it's Lamar Irving, and it's the guys around Lamar that make that thing happen. And so it's a great challenge, and that's why we do this. I was probably most proud of our guys for just challenging every snap. Nobody hung their head when things didn't go right, and they just kept bearing down, which ends up being important, very important when you're playing this crew, and they're mentally tough football team. So you've got to equal that or better that.